Frustrations are growing within the Hollister School District. Tonight, board members voted to lay off 71 teachers to help close a $6.5 million budget deficit. Despite the unpopular move, the pain is far from over, as board members tabled their decision on how many classified employees to cut. Action News reporter Stephanie Truong is live in Hollister to kick off our phone coverage.
Aaron, about 100 people packed the boardroom here tonight, upset with the district's decisions and worried about the cuts it still has to make. Six-year-old Michaela Payne and her nine-year-old sister Danielle love their Sunny Slope school library.
If I can and I get a chance, I would read every day.
When they heard the Hollister School District might shut their library down,
I was really kind of sad because it was kind of my favorite thing, reading books.
The possible library closure goes hand in hand with the layoff of many librarians, along with dozens of other classified employees. They include computer lab supervisor Michelle Smith, who's worked for the district for 26 years.
My husband was laid off a year and a half ago. He has not found a job. So for my job to be threatened and to think that I might not have health insurance, which is a really big concern personally, is just a very scary thing for me.
Tuesday night, board members decided to delay that decision, but that was not the case for 71 teachers. The board voted to let them go in a move to close a $6.5 million deficit.
I voted no on that, saddened that it was a 4-1 majority.
The district says its hands are tied, but former board member and current teacher Debbie Booth insists that this is a situation that could have been avoided. She says the district has lost up to $4 million this year, allowing 600 students to transfer to schools in other districts.
A school district makes money by putting children in the seats here locally. That's called average daily attendance. And that's where the huge, vast majority of our money comes from.
Why would you drop the ball?
Parents are frustrated, including James Payne, who says he may now move his two daughters, Michaela and Danielle, out of the district altogether.
We love Hollister, but my kids' education comes first.
And for them, what comes first is their library.
Do not close the library because people need a place to learn to read.
The Hollister School District has delayed its decision on which classified employees to cut until its meeting in 2 weeks. That's in 2 weeks. But even after that discussion is over, they still have more to talk about because the district is facing another $6.5 million in the red for the following school year. Erin?
All right, Stephanie, thank you. There was also another point of contention at tonight's meeting. One board member, Dr. Alice Flores, tried to censure board member Beatrice Gonzalez Ramirez for sending out a district-wide email criticizing the superintendent who is on sick leave. Flores did pull the item off the agenda, but discussion about the controversy stalled the meeting for at least 30 minutes tonight.